Hello, my soccer universe. The Champions League draw for the round of 16 happened today, and I had to wait a little bit until I had all the dates for the round of 16 matchups, but also to have my simulations finished. So yeah, a little bit later than I planned, but you know, everything is a little bit later. I also decided to put this ahead of all the weekend review videos because it's a little bit more perfect, and then we can go on to those. You will get a lot of videos in very short succession now. It is what it is. So let's get to the draw. Here it is in the order. You have the pots and you have the order in which the matches were drawn. The first one, Manchester City against Gladbach. And again, yes, I have the pot one team listed first. I know that UEFA listed them the other way around, but I actually think this is more reasonable because the City team has, in a way, the home field advantage because they have the return leg at home. So first, Manchester City, Gladbach. Big game for Gladbach, but I think it will be Manchester City all the way. Same thing, Bayern, Lazio. I mean, this was the potentially softest opponent. However, Lazio did play well in the Champions League, so let's see. But from rating-wise and so on, Lazio is the lowest opponent, and most people said it's a very soft draw for Bayern. Bayern will cruise through that. Then Atletico Madrid came out, and who will get Atletico? Nah, it will be Chelsea. And that, I have to say, is a rather even matchup. I like the squad depth of Chelsea a little bit more than the one of Atletico. However, I think if Atletico can string together two good performances and not get too defensive as they are prone to do now, and I'll talk about that as well, I think Chelsea could win it. But I think if Atletico has two, as I said, two performances, I think Atletico Madrid can also win it. But that's pretty much a toss-up. Liverpool-Leipzig, another very exciting game. I mean, Liverpool draws one offensively-minded opponent after the other. And Liverpool is the master. Klopp is the master in a way in that high intensity style. So I would give Liverpool a nod, but it's not a foregone conclusion, this one. Juve Porto. When Porto came out, I thought, yeah, to have at least one Italian go on, I would like Juve to go. Yeah, Juve. I think Juve, despite not being strong, they got luck in that one, and I would favor Juve in that one. And then when Barcelona came out, please PSG. I'm wearing PSG. I have not made it, but you know, we saw Neymar got injured yesterday. I have not an update. I hope he will be fit. So after Messi, Ronaldo, we get Messi, Neymar, and PSG to get revenge on Barcelona. As we will see, my model thinks still Barcelona are the favorites, but I personally would put PSG in the role of the favorites here. Dortmund against Sevilla, kind of a little bit second rate. I would favor Dortmund still, and then Real Madrid, Atalanta, another one of those. I'm curious to see, I mean, how this one will go. Real Madrid are favorites. We don't need to talk about that one. But if Atalanta can be Atalanta, that could be a fun matchup to watch. I also want to give you the draw probabilities. And we very curiously, we never got one of the we never got rid of most favored matchup. It was went all more towards the middle, like Bayern against Lazio. I think it was only the third most likely opponent, similar Real Madrid, Atalanta was also in the third. City had many more. I think there we got the likeliest one with Gladbach. Liverpool also only got, I think, the second one, and so on and so on. So it was always going more down the middle. It was a little bit more of an outside draw in that sense. How did the draw change the chances of winning? Well, the top three still remain the same, and I don't like that necessarily because Barcelona doesn't get punished. But I know how the rating is made. As long as Barcelona loses one and wins one, they will have only a slow decline, so Barcelona is still highly rated there. The big winner of the draw is Real Madrid, who shoot up. I think they were only eighth or something like that. Now they shoot up into fourth spot there. Our favorite, of course, 62%. You can also see the favorites in the different matchups. We also have Juventus making a huge leap, and Atalanta a little bit as well over Sevilla. Sevilla, of course, playing against Dortmund. So the biggest favorites are, of course, Bayern over Lazio. As I said, this is second strongest in the ratings over Lazio, which is the weakest one. And also Manchester City over Gladbach seems to be very clear matchup there. Then it's all already Juve against Porto, and then Dortmund, Real Madrid over Atalanta, and then Dortmund over Sevilla. So yeah, you see that we have a few tight matches, but I have to say, except maybe for the Chelsea Atletico Madrid, that might be the tightest of them all. Liverpool 55% against Leipzig. I also find that one a rather tight affair. I don't think that we will get a tight affair between Barcelona and PSG, but remains to be seen. The matchups also, we get, of course, a big Barcelona PSG matchup right off the bat, and Leipzig Liverpool. I think the star matchups, in a way, are right on the first day. There, then a week later, we also get Atletico against Chelsea. So yeah, you see, it's a little bit all spread out, but I have to say, of the four match days, I probably the first one is the one that I prefer the most, but of course I will watch as many as I can. And then the return legs, it's a little bit, it's turned around. So we will get first Dortmund and Sevilla, and it finishes. We'll see who will progress between Chelsea and Atletico. That will be also quite interesting. So let me know who you favor in these four matchups. Who do you think will go on further in the Champions League? Who are your favorites to win it all? I said my model at the moment says Manchester City. Let's see how that goes. Give me a thumbs up if you enjoyed this video. Subscribe to my channel if you want to see more, and I will talk to you soon. Bye. Hey there. I really hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, here are some videos and playlists that you might enjoy too. Also, please consider subscribing to my channel and clicking the little bell icon so that I get updated whenever something is happening in my soccer universe. And with that, have a wonderful day.